The new control rule feature in Mike Hydro Basin helps you quickly and easily introduce your own regulation rules in a water allocation model. In this example, there's a catchment with two water users in series taking water from the same river branch. You can see that while the upstream water user, the yellow line, is fully supplied with water, the downstream user, the orange line, has deficits in large parts of the simulation period. But if the downstream water user should be given priority over the upstream one, you can use the new control rule feature to give priority to the downstream user. To do this, click Setup to go back to the model setup. Shift the view from Map to Tabular. The control section in the menu has two subsections, one for sensors and one for control rules. Mike Hydro Basin's control rules operate based on sensors. So first, specify the sensors that will be used to define the rules. Click on the plus sign to add a new sensor. Next, give the sensor a name and define your parameters. Here, we're adding five sensors. Two are internal, reading the state of the model and checking the flow at the upstream and downstream ends of the river. Two are external time series describing the water demand of each water user. The last one is an external time series representing the upstream return flow fraction. Next, add a control rule to manipulate the water demand for the upstream water user. Give it a name and define the parameters. You can even add a description to specify the purpose. Next, click the Conditions and Actions tab to set actions that will take place if specific conditions are met. Add a new condition and click Edit to define it. You can quickly and easily insert your sensors from the drop-down menu to write your expression. Click Validate to check for errors, and now choose an action. In this example, we will manipulate the water use time series of the upstream water user to ensure the downstream user needs are met. The first condition will tell the model not to provide any water to the upstream water user if the flow is not enough to supply the downstream user. In other words, if the upstream diversion point is less than or equal to the downstream water demand. The second condition will tell the model what to do if the flow is sufficient to fulfill all the downstream user's demand, but only part of the upstream user's demand. That is, if the upstream diversion point is less than the sum of the upstream and downstream user demands. Now, check that your new control rule has solved the problem. Go back to the map display, and then click Run to validate your setup. Since there are no errors or warnings, you can now run the model. Check that all time steps are there to be sure the execution is correct. In the original simulation, the orange line for the downstream water user demonstrated the large water deficit during some parts of the year. Now, let's compare it to the new results. Create a new plot to check the supply to each water user. Now, we can see that the control rule has given full priority to the downstream water user at the expense of the upstream one. And that's how you can use control rules in a water allocation model with Mike Hydro Basin.